today I am going to be editing one of your photos. What up, simpletons? This was an idea suggested by one of my followers, and I thought it was such a great idea that I would go ahead and do it. Thank you to everyone that submitted a photo. I loved putting a face to y'all and seeing all of your great shots. So the random generator chose number 6, and if we look at our Excel file, it looks like Randy is our winner. Congratulations, Randy. I will be editing your photo for this video today. So Randy actually had a really cute story, and Randy, I hope you don't mind that I'm sharing, but he told me that his wife doesn't think she's pretty enough. I think she's absolutely beautiful, and so does he, and so he wanted my help, even though I think he captured her beauty all on his own. This is a photo of Randy's wife, Annie. Annie, if you're watching this, I love your outfit. My editing style hasn't changed much from my first editing tutorial, so the first thing we're gonna do is tune image. The lighting in this photo is already good, so we're just gonna increase the brightness by a little bit. We're going to up the contrast by a little bit as well. I'm not gonna go too crazy with ambience, so I'm just gonna up it by about 7. Highlights, I'm also gonna keep at a minimal, and I'm gonna up the shadows by a little bit as well. Next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into details, and we're going to up the structure and up the sharpen. Then, if you've been following along, our next step is HDRscape. I don't like to go too much on HDRscape because it does look a little bit cartoonish or animated, so we are going to go about 32. And then one of my favorite features, grainy film. So grainy film is really helpful for that vintage flair, vintage edit to your photos. X03 and X04 are my favorites. I kind of like X04 for this photo. I'm not gonna add a ton of grain, I'm just gonna add about 5. And then in terms of the style strength, I'm not gonna go to 100% because I think that washes out Annie a fair bit. So I'm only gonna go about 40. And then I'm gonna go back into grainy film again and layer it with X03. But I'm not gonna add any grain because I've already added it to X04. So now our next step is curves. And curves can literally take a picture from drab to fab within seconds. If you guys are still confused about how to use curves, I'm going to link to you a more detailed video on how I use curves below. For this case, I am just gonna go about it quite quickly. Let's start with luminous, about there. And then we'll go to the red curve. I don't wanna make her too red. Now we're gonna go to the green curve. And there is a lot of greenery within the shot already. I don't wanna amp it up too much because I want the focal point to be on Annie. All right, now we're gonna go to the blue curve and play with that a little bit as well. And then our last curve is the RGB curve. All right, so there you go. We didn't go too drastic with curves because I didn't want to change the overall tone of the shot completely. But now we're gonna go into white balance, and I'm gonna make the picture a little bit warmer. So I'm gonna up the temperature by 5, and I'm gonna up the tint by 2. That just adds a little bit more pink into the shot. So I love Annie's polka dot top, and I love her purse. I'm going to accentuate it with the saturation feature within brush. So let's go to tools, brush, and let's up saturation to 10. It's already up at 10, so we're good. So I'm actually going to brush over her top and her bag, and as you can see, it brightens up the red within the purse and the top. I like her nails as well, and I'm just gonna do it on the jeans. So I love her nude lip color, but I kind of want it to show a little bit more, so I'm gonna lower saturation down to 5. I'm gonna do a light brush over her lips just to accentuate more of that nude. So I think Annie has a gorgeous face, but I want to accentuate it a little bit more, so we're gonna go to tools and we're gonna go to portrait. You can play around with the different combinations that are already been laid out for you. If we go and click on the different combos, you can see Annie's face kind of change, but I wanna customize it to my own liking. So if we go to the middle toggle icon and go to face spotlight, what it does is going to illuminate Annie's face so that when we look at the picture, our eyes will go straight to her face and that will be the focal point. It essentially brightens her complexion up. If I go to 100, it darkens everything else and her face is illuminated, but I don't wanna do that because she's not a ghost. So we're only gonna go about 44. All right, I think we're done. So let's do a final before and after. So this is before and this is after. You can see a difference, the colors pop more, and there's a lot more warmth. So there we go, Randy, I hope you liked it, and I hope your wife Annie loved it as well. If you don't like the edit, that's fine. Everyone has their own preference. This is just my specific style and how to edit. I know everyone has their own. It just goes to show that you can really apply the same technique onto any photo. It doesn't matter what camera it was taken on or what the lighting was, whether it was a phone or a DSLR. All you gotta do is apply the basic techniques, obviously to your preference, and your photo will come out looking great regardless. So give this video a thumbs up if you want me to do more fan edits. Comment below your Insta handle if you want your photo edited, but also don't forget to email me your photo just to keep the quality of the photo intact. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and join the Simpleton family. All right, I will see you guys next time. Bye.
Okay, bye.